making the classic roll collar coat. Part 13, the sleeves. This is the sleeve crown, also called the sleeve head or sleeve cap. The crown nearly always needs to be eased into the armhole, and we want to do this evenly without pleats or tucks, unless that is the feature of the design. To help distribute this fullness, we use two rows of gathering stitches either side of the seam line. Use a contrast thread to make it easy to remove. Right, I have my sleeve crown under the foot, and the fabric is facing right side up. I have loosened the top tension and lengthened the stitch a little. I'm starting from the notch and stitching about an eighth of an inch inside the seam allowance. Stitch all the way round to the notch on the other side. Then repeat this, but this time about an eighth of an inch on the other side of the seam line. So the gathering threads are in. Now we can join the sleeve seam. Matching notches and making sure these cuff lines are matched. So just pin and stitch. Just pivot your stitching at these angles. The seam is stitched, and before we press, we must clip at these points to remove excess bulk. So, using the sleeve board for what it was designed for, we now press the seam open. This linen cotton mix fabric is probably okay to arm without a cloth, but it pays to be cautious. We have two sleeves, right side out and pressed, ready to sew into our garment. Our garment is inside out. Pop the sleeve into the armhole, making sure you have them the right way around by matching the notches. Match the underarm seams and the notch at the top of the sleeve to the shoulder seam. Match the notches and pin. You find the lower half of the sleeve curve and armhole curve will match. Then we are ready to ease the crown. By pushing the sleeve into the armhole like this, you will see that the amount of ease required is very little in this pattern. Get hold of the two threads and pull up a little. Then just ease and distribute the fullness evenly. And pin at right angles. When you are happy that you have the right amount of gathering, wind the threads round a pin to secure until you machine. Do the same on the other side. Take your time and use plenty of pins. Yes, I think that will do. So let's get this seam stitched. Don't forget to change your thread back to the matching machine thread. and set your tension back to normal. Take it carefully, stitching this seam is a little awkward. As always, sew slowly over the pins. You should be stitching between the gathering rows. Nearly there. You need to keep rotating your garment so that the seam lies flat. Check your sleeve before removing your gathering threads. Try the coat on or use a dress form if you have one. That is looking pretty good considering it hasn't been pressed and doesn't have the shoulder pads in yet. Yes, I'm happy with that. So that's both sleeves sewn in. We can now remove the gathering stitches. As long as you haven't machined over them, they should pull out quite easily. The next job is to run another row of stitching along this seam, a quarter of an inch inside the seam allowance. Next, we're going to trim this seam and add the shoulder pads. Sewing tutorials supported by AngelaKane.com membership, sewing pattern sales, and fan funding. For news of up and coming videos, please subscribe to our channel. Once subscribed, set your preferences to be notified by email. Thank you very much for watching.